Iron Mountain Road. If you've already enjoyed the beauty of Needles Highway and the Wildlife Loop Road, there's one last drive that's a must-see: Iron Mountain Road. It's without question the most scenic route to Mount Rushmore from Custer State Park. I'll explain why later. As I mentioned on the last track, if you're coming from the Wildlife Loop Road, just head east on Highway 16A. You'll have to leave the park and then make a quick left. Iron Mountain Road is a continuation of 16A. Only a small portion of this road lies within the park. Were it not for dogged determination, the road you're driving on might not be here. The reason has to do with a man named Peter Norbeck, former governor of South Dakota. Does that name ring a bell? A number of things around the park are named after him, with good reason. Why? Well, it's time for another history lesson, but don't worry, I'll be brief. Peter Norbeck was instrumental in establishing Custer State Park. When Norbeck came up with the idea of mapping out a scenic byway that would capture the beauty of these ancient mountains, opposers told him that he was crazy. They said that such a route couldn't be built. Undaunted, Norbeck set out on foot and horseback and patiently mapped out the route. Today, Iron Mountain Road is part of the Peter Norbeck National Scenic Byway. As you will see on this drive, Iron Mountain Road is proof that Peter Norbeck sure knew a thing or two about capturing beauty. As you're driving on Iron Mountain Road, keep on the lookout for a sign that says Black Hills National Forest. The sign will be on your left. Directly across the road from the sign is a place where you can pull off. An information sign gives some details about the Black Hills National Forest. But what I like to point out is that if you look to the west, in the distance, through the trees, you can actually see Mount Rushmore. It's a rare glimpse that few people actually get to see. Along the highway, be prepared to see more of the same animals that you saw on the Wildlife Loop Road. Take advantage of the numerous scenic overlooks and picnic areas. Expect to take about an hour for the drive. In addition to the wildlife and natural wonders, there are some man-made marvels to behold along the way. As you continue on toward Mount Rushmore, there are three one-lane tunnels you'll pass through. These granite tunnels have been carefully constructed to frame the sculpted faces on Mount Rushmore. As you approach the first and third tunnels, get ready for a unique view of the four most famous men in rock. Granite, that is. As Iron Mountain Road winds its way down toward Keystone, there are three unique engineering marvels you'll come to: the Pigtail Bridges. Get ready to go over the curliest bridges you'll ever see. You'll understand what I mean when you wrap around and go under the bridges. Please drive slowly, the bridges are narrow and steep. After the last bridge, look for the sign that says Pigtail Bridges, where there's room to pull off the road. The sign explains how and why these unusual log bridges were built. By the way, the bridges are neither straight, nor level, nor flat. At the bottom of this hill, if you want to go on to Mount Rushmore, turn left onto 244 and follow the signs. On the other hand, if you want to get a bite to eat or do a little shopping for gifts, souvenirs, or trinkets, bear to the right and go to Keystone. This fun little town is just 2 miles from Mount Rushmore. When you're ready, next up is a visit to the sculpted masterpiece that has stirred the emotions of many a visitor, Mount Rushmore.